Welcome to my presentation, Stadium 4.0, a turnkey solution from Kista. So my name is Thomas Walter. I'm working for Kista. Kista is a worldwide active company with more than 2,000 employees and different locations all over the world. And I'm a biomechanics expert for Kista and also sales engineer in the German-speaking region. So when you have any questions, you can also contact me on the private address. The presentation is about Stadium 4.0. So Kista is active in a wide area of industry, and one field is the biomechanics and represented by the stadium here. And what do we think about Stadium 4.0? Here you can see the overview of all kind of sports type and different measurement solutions we offer for this kind of stadium 4.0. So you can have a sprint solution, baseball application, a special starting blocks for swimming in the gym. You can have one or two plate system for strength and power tests. You can also have a pole board planting box and everything possible with one or more force plates in a mobile or in a stationary concept. So this presentation is about Stadium 4.0 and what's possible with the new digital techniques. So, and a little bit about project management. So what is necessary to build a Stadium 4.0 and connect all necessary systems, and what we have to think about when you plan such a project. So it starts with a first contact, and that's about sharing your vision, what you want to measure, what kind of data you want to generate. Is it for sports science? Do you have a gym and want to visualize parameters and so on? The next step is the solution definition. So we at Kista think about what is your need, which kind of sensors do you need, which kind of measurement system, software behind, which algorithms to calculate the parameter, and so on. Then we develop the products, so specialized sensors or specialized software for your project, and implement it in your site. So at any place in the world, in a gym, in a hall, in a laboratory, whatever. And afterwards, we do training, also like now in a video conference or at the site for our software, for specialized sensor, or for just standard biomechanical education and training. And for us, the sales is not over when the system is working in your site. So we also offer support and service afterwards, for example, calibration or software upgrades and so on. So it starts with the first contact, and it's not about knowing how a force plate works. It's not about doing calculations on forces and moments. And it's not about knowing that piezoelectric sensors have a higher damping and higher natural frequency than strain gauge. But it's about getting to know your vision. So You have to share your vision with us. What do you expect? What kind of measurements do you want to do? So if you need any special sensor for a special sport, like a starting block or pole vault, for example, do you need for research a special glass plate where you can measure forces and still have a camera underneath to make camera vision? Also special surfaces like here for shot part discus and hammer throwing is possible. Do you have installations where you need a lot of sensors, so not just 8 or 10 force plates, but a lot more, like here in a sprint track, for example? Or do you work for an insurance and need special tests to prove if any rehabilitation is doing fine or not, or if any customer or client of you is cheating to just get money? And maybe you need also special algorithms to analyze this cheating. Or another possibility, for example, would be this waterproof force plates when you do jumps underwater. That's also possible. When you think about optimizing your equipment, your tools in an ergonomic way, that would be one idea. Or in a wind tunnel to measure loads during a simulated flight. When you need stairs, for example, for prosthesis development, where the ground track and also every step is measuring and also can be adjusted in length and height, or for ski jump, or also for animal tests, that would be possible. So just think about what you want to do and share the dream with us, and we will think about the measurement solution to do that. And yeah, so we come to the solution definition. I will share some steps you need to think about to come to a good biomechanical system. There could be also some additional steps necessary depending on your site and what you especially want to do. So first would be to think about if you need a mobile or a stationary plate. So mobile have the advantage that you can transport them, that you can place them anywhere you want. Stationary have better technical issues and have the problem, the disadvantage that they have to be mounted to the ground. Then the number of the force plates is very important. So do you think about just one single plate to doing jumps, for example, or clinical studies, or do you want a whole match field put with force plates and also want to measure strategic behavior between the people, interaction between the players and so on. So that's one big issue to think about. Next would be to plan if it should be an indoor or an outdoor biomechanical measurement place. Next is, do you want to have a special sport surface on the force plate, like here tartan, for example, and should it be fixed, like here in the left picture on the force plate? It has a lot of advantages, for example, better COP correctness, or should it be like in that system on separate top plates, like here shown, which are mounted on the force plate. It has the advantage that it is exchangeable, so you can put different kind of surfaces on a force plate, on different kind of top plates on a force plate. So you need only one force plate and can put parquet or tartan on top, for example. That's an advantage, but the COP correctness is not so good as when you put the the soft sports surface directly on the force plate. Then there are so you can choose different types of top surfaces depending on the sport you are doing or what you want to do on measurement in the laboratory. So one example would be this top plate with tartan, for example. Or one top plate is ceramics, for example, for discus and shot put. And the aim is that that you reach a flat surface so that you have only a small gap around the force plate to the ground, but the surface is flat. And you can select from different sizes of force plates which are already available, or we can also customize a force plate and develop special dimensions if needed. When you're sure which kind of force plates and where you want to install the force plates, it's about the installation. So to reach a flat surface, you have to put the force plates into a pit. So you have to dig this pit into the ground, and you can mount the force plates on anchors, like shown here. You have to drill holes, put anchors in, glue them, and mount the force plate on top of the anchors. Or you can use frames, like shown on right, left, right top. So. When you want to have a special sport surface, like a parquet for basketball, also on top of the force plates, you have to put the force plates a little bit lower to put the sport surface on top. Not so good for measurement because you have this to do this step on the force plate. But also possible when you are not able to have this pit in your ground because the floor is not thick enough or whatever. You can also put these anchors flat to the surface and mount the force plates on top of these anchors on the ground. So you have to do the step, but you don't have to put this pit in before. And when you're sure about that, it starts with the working on the drawings. So we can provide drawings for your architect and discuss with your architect how the installation should be done, which dimensions the pit needs, what is possible in the ground. Are you on the second or even higher floor in a building, and do you have to think about vibrations in the building, or are you directly on the ground and have a special support that comes in here? And you have also to think about when you, for example, do an outside installation or when your floor is cleaned wet. About a drainage, for example, like shown here. So there are a lot of things to think about before starting such kind of project and installations. When you are clear about that, it comes to all the digital connections you have to consider. The data acquisition and position of the sensors is clear. Where to store my data? It could be in the cloud, it can be a computer on site, it can be a server on site, which is not available in the whole world, but for our customers of the company, university, or whatever. And how many people need access to this data? Do I need a user management on a sport site? I probably have a manager, coach, and athlete, and they all need access to their data. Or when I'm in a university, I just have one scientist doing all the measurements, and that's it. And how the connection to this data are possible. So do I need, for example, for an athlete on a training site, a mobile application app so that he can start the measurement and stop the measurement on his mobile device, so for example, on a smartphone? Or do I have hardware, so for example, a motion capture system, which needs the force data generated by the force plates? Or do I have special calculation for live feedback training, for example, running in the cloud? So the data needs to be sent to the cloud, the algorithms need to analyze the data and to give direct feedback on a homepage. And when it's not about force data measurement and maybe a motion capture system coming after, you also can think about EMG connections. So, for example, with our new bus technology, all force plates can be connected to any data acquisition device from Kista. So you are also able to measure all these physical values. So, for example, EMG inputs synchronized to the force plate data. So to just mention three motion capture systems which all can communicate and directly import the force data from our force plates would be Vicon, Qualisys, and Zini, and some example to show what's possible there. And one stage more is to have a motion capture system recording videos and the force data, and to send these measured data to a server. There are algorithms analyzing the data, and on a home page, for example, on a mobile device like tablet, smartphone or so, you get direct feedback of the measurement. So within 30 seconds after the measurement, after the trial, you see the force of every step, step length, and impulses calculated, and so on. And directly see the high-speed videos synchronized to the force data, so cursor to the picture. When you're clear about what the system should look like and which parameters you need, which components you need, and how the data path looks like, we start the development and production process. So we think about how to integrate your special sport surface on top of our force plates. How to build special top plates for our force plates, or even how to build whole systems with a special geometry, maybe also special sensors, because you have very small forces, like on this animal test, or bigger systems for human, for example, this swimming starting. Or another way would be to use standard sensors in new applications. To have standard force sensors integrated in this pools or into pedals from bicycles or in ski jump arenas, or to develop special software, for example, for the swimming analysis, where automatically parameters are calculated. And next step is the deployment in your site. So we pack everything together, transport it to your site, and then it's all about the installation of this measurement system you want to have. So about drilling the holes for the anchors, to glue in the frames or anchors to mount the force plates on, inside here and outside installation, to put all the cables in. So that's an installation with digital force plates. You see still mess of cables, even though you have only thin network cables connecting the force plates, and also the installation of some kind of computer rack, for example, if necessary. So you see motion capture systems and all the cameras come together in the same place. And that's nowadays quite easy to have such kind of bigger systems with the new technology of these digital force plates. So you can scale the systems up. You are not limited in the number of force plates. The force plates and all other kinds of data acquisition are synchronizing automatically to each other. You can have longer cables in between the force plates, or even shorter cables when you daisy chain, for example, a sprint track, where the force plates are directly after each other. So it makes a lot easier having this digital technology. And yeah, when the system is running on your site, the work doesn't end. So we offer special trainings for the special hardware in your site, or just for general topics about our software, about sensors, about biomechanical needs you maybe have. And when the training is done, we come to support and services we offer. So, for example, we offer commissioning support when the system is installed. We recommend that it's periodically tested or even calibrated. So we talk about once a year for car industry, and so it's even more often. We offer software updates for any kind of software you need, so local solutions or cloud-based solutions. You can give us advice which parameters are missing in our software, and we try to calculate them and offer them with the next release of our software. We do this general training courses and workshops online or directly at your site. And we also offer setup specifics. So when you have any special sensor, any special setup, also setup specific trainings for your site. So that was a little introduction about our solutions for Stadium 4.0. And I want to continue with the question and answer part. So feel free when you have any questions about digital technologies. Maybe you have a system in mind you want to talk about. We have special questions for us. Please write in the chat or send us an email, and we can answer it after.